Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. I am Anne and this is Annmakes, and I just finished filming a Dollar Tree haul and perhaps some of my studio. And I say perhaps because I actually haven't filmed it, but I don't know if I want to include the clip, if I will have time to film and include it with the Dollar Tree haul video or not. But anyway, right now I have a Dollarama haul to share with you and a little update on my studio. So stay tuned to see all of that if you're interested. So last time in my video, I showed you that I had found these storage bins that I am absolutely in love with because I went to a different Dollarama, and lo and behold, my Dollarama just got them. So I'm so excited. And they also received these smaller ones. Isn't that great? Now I got another one of these ones, the $4 bins that can store regular size sheets of paper, like typewriting paper or copy paper. And I got two of the little ones, and the little ones are $3, and they hold 1.2 liters or 40.5 ounces. And I just want to show you what's kind of neat about these ones is that they stack like that. And I just think these are really fun to use all over your house for organizing. But of course, for me, they're going in my craft room /studio. And I just want to show you in case you missed my previous Dollarama haul video. So they have these. They're very nice quality. I am loving these bins. And oh, my Dollarama had just received some more of these beautiful blankies, and I was debating between getting this kind of rose rusty color and a bright pink, and I decided to get this one. And I'm not sure, now that I got it home, it looks really like a rust color, but I kind of like it. So I like pinks and reds, so of course this will be my blankie for my studio, Sandy. Sandy knows what I'm talking about. New at my Dollarama are these Sharpie Clear View, and I love the highlighters and I love Sharpies, and these are the kind that the tip, you can actually sort of see through the tip as you're highlighting what you're highlighting. Kind of neat. So there's three in here in three different colors, and they are sold for $3 each package. So you know what, they are a little bit more expensive if you go to the office supply store. So I was happy to pick these up at Dollarama, and I just love pens and pencils and markers and all that stuff. Now the next thing I have to share with you is strange. It's really bizarre looking, but it is called a wire collar, and it looks like chicken wire with pearls in it. And they show here how they tend to use it with like flower arrangements or in a wreath or something. It's a decorative thing, decorative crafty thing. And this is 8 inches in diameter, and it is $3. It doesn't look like 8 inches because it's kind of squished, but you kind of open it up when you take it out of the package. This is new to me completely at my Dollarama, and this is a As Seen on TV product, the Naked Nails, natural shiny nails in seconds. Gentle on nails, lasts up to 2 weeks, and easy to use. So apparently if you want to have your natural looking nails look very nice and healthy, you follow the instructions, use this tool, and then by miracle they will look gorgeous. We will see about that, but I thought I would give it a whirl for $4. I saw this in the Valentine's decorations, and I just thought it was a lovely shade of pink, and it's roses, and I know it's decor for Valentine's Day, and I just got it because I thought it would really look really nice for Valentine's Day, but it might also be a cute decoration to put in my office. And these are $2.50. I got this package of binder clips. I was in need of some binder clips, and I really wanted pink, so I got this package. So, but I'll find a use or I'll give away the blue and the yellow. Oh, back in the beauty aisle, they have these nail file. They're like a matchbook. Nail files, Lori, there's 5 little nail files in here for $1.25, and you flip it open, this, and you break, there's 5 nail files in here to break off, so. And they're just really cute and pretty. They fit well in a purse, and but they also make a nice little gift for someone. So I got this design and this design because those were the pinkish kind of designs they had. And they have other designs too. I just thought these are really fun. This to me was new in the craft aisle at Dollarama. It is a metallic gravel. So it's a gravel and metallic colors. I like shiny stuff, and I thought, oh, okay, I'll add this to my stash. You got these 3 bottles, and they have weight in their gravel, so they're pretty heavy. And it doesn't say how much there is in terms of ounces or anything like that, but they're $1.50. I was very pleased to find some of the Martha Stewart stickers. I had seen some other people haul. This is all that my store had. I guess I was late to the party, so, but I'm very happy that I did find these. These are $1.25. I also got a Sticko one with the little Cupids. They're so cute for Valentine's Day, and these are also $1.25. And I also got these little heart stickers in these nice pastel type of colors, and I believe this was $1. Another thing I've seen other people haul are these cute little mini love notes, and I just thought these are really sweet, and I hope to have the time to make pocket letters. I don't know if I will, but these would be perfect for that. Or in friend mail, these are $1.25 each package, and you get 6 in each. And this I think is a really good deal. For $1.25, you get the 4 sheets of stickers, and they're chipboard with glitter. So you get this set, and followed by, basically it's the same set twice. So you get 3 sheets like that, and then you get all these nice flat stickers with sayings on them. And like I said, I think I said it, $1.25 for all of that. I picked up a big card for Valentine's Day because I'm afraid I won't have time to make my own this year. So, got that. And these are new to me, the Betty Crocker Steam and Serve Microwave Cooking Bags. I thought I would try these out. There are 3 large bags in here. Apparently they measure 10 inches by 10 inches. They're for steaming vegetables in the microwave. I've tried a similar product in the past, and I thought it was fun and practical. And there's 6 bags in here, sorry. There's 3 large bags and 3 medium bags in each package, a total of 6, and they are $1.25 each. It was in need of some toothpaste, so I picked up the Colgate Sensitive Whitening for $2.50. This is new to me. I don't know if anybody else has seen these. These are magnets, and they are called Embellish Your Story. Apparently it's create your story magnets. So this one had the barn on here, and this one had these flowers. I just thought they were pretty. I got them. I thought there's a crafty use for them for sure. So new at Dollarama, at my Dollarama, were these multi-purpose storage bins by Plastico. They seem to be of an excellent quality if I can tear them apart, and I did. I have another one right now that I'm being used by my contractor as a measurement, because I'm going to be using these, of course, in my studio. I love, they're really sturdy, quality clear acrylic, and they say that these are freezer safe, which is really good to know, because a lot of plastic containers are not that great in the freezer. I don't know if I've had that happen to me, that I put a plastic basket or bin or container in the freezer, and if I banged it or accidentally dropped it, it cracks. But this apparently is made for the freezer, so it's supposed to be sturdy, and it is quite a nice size, and it measures 14.5 inches in length. It is about 4.5 inches, 4.25 inches high, I think, and 4 inches wide. And it has these handles, and they say they were stackable. I have a hard time stacking them without them falling into each other, but apparently they can be stacked. And did I say it? These are $3. And you know, I love storage bins, so I had to get those. I got the flannel back tablecloth for Valentine's Day. These are $3.50. I got this one in the pink with all the hearts on it. I got actually two of these, so I can put these in my studio in my craft room when I'm gonna be ready to move my supplies. And I can cover my brand new counters with it, and you know, not worry too much about scratching them. Garbage bags for the kitchen. These are $1.25, I believe. Yeah, scented garbage bags. And I picked up this bin thing organizer for, it's for over the cabinet kitchen storage. As you can see, there's a lip here, so this kind of hangs on the door of your cabinet, inside or outside, whatever you want. And it's just a place to put like maybe the dish soap and other things. And I'm probably going to end up using this in my studio or craft room. Or actually, you can use this in a bathroom too, anywhere. This is just anywhere there's a door or a cabinet, you know, anywhere you have a little bar to hang. Just a handy dandy thingamajig storage, $3.50. And it kind of has this frosted, almost clear plastic, so it's not, you know, that's how I describe it, frosted plastic. And I also got this one, which is another over-the-door storage basket. This one is the wire kind, in white, and this is also $3. It's the same intention as the plastic one, but I might be using this to hold some tools on my workbench or my work at my workspace. So that's what I thought of doing with that. So the next thing I want to show you before the contractors come back in the house and make more noise is these pads of 16 by 20 die cuts with a view, a premium stack of paper, and these are glitzy neutrals. So they are essentially like a card stock, or not really a card stock. They're a glossy paper coated with this beautiful glitter, and it doesn't come off. Very nice shiny paper. There are 8 sheets in here of the 16 by 20. There are templates at the back, so you can follow the instructions to make the following projects or use the paper in any way you would like. As you can see, I purchased 2 of these and they are $4, and I think this is an excellent buy. Same haul as I did on Tuesday, videotaping it has been a challenge because I have the constant interruptions. And like I said, it's Friday now, so it's almost done. Let's just go plow through this. So the other items I wanted to show you are the pads of paper that I picked up at my Dollarama. My Dollarama finally got some nice pads of paper. I love this. This one is called the Treasures Pad by DCWV, which is die cuts with a view. And there are, it says it's a premium stack. There are 24 sheets with special treatments, and it's a total of, I believe, 48 sheets of this 12 by 12 paper. And I'm just gonna show you up close what it looks like. And the special treatment on each paper is that they have some embossing and some glossiness. This looks just exactly like the Dymo tape, you know, that the kind that you have a little wheel thing and you punch the letters and you advance the wheel. It feels almost the same as that. There's other papers with that are embossed. This one has this leathery feel to it. Even some typewriter keys, those are raised. So it's got a lot of really neat papers inside that are all very vintage, antique-y looking. You know, if you know, especially for people who like that look, and I love the look of vintage, old flea market style. So, I got two of these pads and they are $4. Add were the DCWV again, DIY project set, and this one is to make the paper roses. Now, these are the projects that come with, the instructions are available inside this pad. And what is really, really neat about this is that in this pad, each page is the die cuts. It's all die cuts that you punch out. You see that? You just punch them out. And each page, it's the exact same die cuts, but all you have different colors too. You have the white ones, you have all these red ones, and you have the, and then you have the ones with a print on it. And at the back, there's the instructions of how to put together these projects. So this is a lot of fun. If you're looking for a paper crafting project to make and there's no fussy cutting involved, you just punch out the pieces, follow the instructions with a little bit of adhesive, usually mostly glue or double-sided tape, you can put together some of these really beautiful projects. So I think this is a really fun buy, $4. I have to share with you of goodies that I purchased are things that are gonna end up in my new studio, which, by the way, I did make a little video of that, and I will be including that at the end of this Dollarama haul. And I got this wall-mounted paper towel holder. It's really nice quality. It is $4. It's very nice stainless steel, strong, sturdy, and I guess, how do you put this? Yeah, you attach it to the wall like this, and you put the roll here, and it's not flimsy, it doesn't seem flimsy at all. So I got this, and I thought, well, I could use it for other things in my cupboards, in my studio perhaps. So I just bought one, but I thought I might actually go back and buy some others, because besides hanging paper towel rolls, you could hang all sorts of rolls of things. You could hang towels and whatnot. So I thought that was a pretty good deal for $4. I picked up another one of these mug warmers by Betty Crocker. I already have a couple of these in my current studio craft room in the basement. And so I purchased a new one for my new studio because I will be needing this in my new studio. And I just thought I would leave the old ones downstairs in our office area, just because it's very cold down there in the winter, and it's just nice to put our cup of coffee down on a mug warmer. And I'm not completely moved out of the basement, and it's gonna take me probably a year before I am. So I just wanna make sure I have a spot to keep my coffee warm. And finally, the last item I have to show you is the wire basket here. This is, Rama design for Dollarama, like Rama design. And these wire baskets are $4. You can see the size there. These are really nice. This is like a dark brown or black color. It's hard to tell in the light here. And I might actually spray paint this white to go with my studio. So that's that for the Dollarama haul. I hope you like that. I hope that you like these little videos I'm throwing in here with my, they're all haul videos, nothing crafting yet. And I hope you'll also like seeing little glimpses of what my studio is looking like in the process of building it. And I promise when the studio is built, I will show it all, and I will also start making some more crafty videos. I am going on a big business trip next week. I will have a lot to share with you. I am hoping that while I am at Creativation in Phoenix, that I will have the time and also good enough Wi-Fi so I could probably send you, I could maybe send you some clips, maybe some videos, some pictures of all that's new that's coming out in the crafting industry. And so look out for that. I'll do my best about it. If not, there will definitely be a recap once I return, and that will probably be like the beginning of February. So thank you so much for supporting my channel, for supporting me, and I hope that you like, that you give it a thumbs up, comment, share, and promise me to take care of yourself until I see you again, and so take care. Bye-bye for now. So here's an update on the status of my new craft room slash studio. As you can see, the inspector is here checking out everything, making sure it's to cat code, I guess. So it hasn't met your approval so far? You're still thinking about it? Okay. So what has been accomplished so far is now all the cupboards are installed, and there's cupboards going around on that side, and this is the island which we fussed on the design and fussed over the design, and I am so pleased with how it's going to look in the end. I can envision it now. Yes, it's an octagonal island. It has a great work area, and it is also very space efficient. It's actually taking less square footage on the floor but providing more workspace. So yeah, this is awesome, and there will be room for friends to come craft with me. That is the best part of it. So four people can sit very comfortably at this work area, this work table island. The garbage is finally out of here, and here are the other cupboards that just got put up today on this side. On this side it goes around, and we have a few more cupboards there and some drawers here at the bottom. So that is the update, and there is the inspector who's kind of going cuckoo right now, testing out the plywood base. I think she likes to sink her claws into the wood. It won't be staying plywood, sorry, it's going to be covered with a counter. Yes, but she is certainly having a great time there and getting herself covered in sawdust and dust in general. So that is that. I hope you are enjoying these small updates that I am bringing you, and I look very much forward to the next update and the next, and I really am most looking forward to the end. Thank you so much for watching.